Hello students, as you are observing on board, today we are going to discuss division of integers. What? So let's start to do this operation, basic operations on integers. Division of integers is little bit inverse operation, inverse than multiplication. Always remember that if we are dividing two same sign numbers, I'm using the word same sign numbers, or in place of same sign, we can use integer. If we are dividing two same sign integers, then result is always positive. Always remember, all of you, division of same sign integer. Same sign integer gives you the result as a positive one. Hope this one is clear to you, na? And if division of different sign, what we are discussing is about integers, na? Different sign gives you the negative result. This one is also clear. This is as same as multiplication, but in this case, division of same sign integers gives the positive one. Division of same different sign integer gives you the negative result. Move to some properties. Okay, one more thing is there. If we divide any integer by zero, it gives you the undefined result. For example, if I am dividing, suppose 14 divided by zero, then this result is undefined. It is not defined yet. Number one, clear? And if we reverse this one, if zero is divided by any number or any integer, gives you zero as a result. Gives you zero as a result. Whatever it is, positive or negative, this is always zero. So this is the some basic rules of division of integers. Now we are going to discuss about properties of division. So small properties are there, properties of division. Remember, we are discussing about properties of division of integers. Remember, whenever an integer divided by an integer, it is not compulsory that they are closer one. Closer means if we divide an integer by an integer, result not always in integer form. For example, c minus 1. I am taking minus 1 pointedly so that you can easily understand. Divided by minus 2. How we represent this one on a line? It's a minus 1 divided by minus 2. This one, negative negative gives you the positive result. So here we have 1 upon 2. See, this one is integer. This one is also an integer. But this is not an integer form. So that's why division of integer not follow the closure property. Move to the next part. As you are observing, division of integers not follow closure properties as well as commutative, associative or distributive properties. It never follow any properties of operation. And second one is whenever we divide any integer by 1, we have the same result, A. Or if we divide any integer A with some negative integer, here I am taking minus 1, so give you the negative result. But in this case, I am talking about negative 1, so it gives you the negative of the integer. So hope this one is clear. Next one is, okay, let's start to solve some question answers so that you can easily understand. Okay, so there are some questions given in your book. In this book, I am picking some questions randomly and try to explain the process of division. The very first question says that divide, simply divide. Okay, pick this one. 72 divided by within bracket minus 8. How you solve? This is the way how to write solution in your copy. So first, 72 divided by minus 8. Then after, here it's a negative, this one is positive. So ultimately result is negative. Now 8, what we can write down? 72 upon 8. Now whenever we divide, 8 1 ja 8, 1 8 9 ja, so it's a minus 9 upon 1, or you can write down 9 minus 9. This is the answer. Now if both integers are negative, then it's a minus 1 2 8 divided by minus 3 2, and it means 32, minus 32. So how we write? Same, we follow the same process. Minus 1 2 8 divided by minus 32, it's a minus minus plus, it's a 1 2 8 by 32. Clear? It's a, see about 4, 4 3s are 12, 4 2s are 8, 4 8s are 32, 4 2s are 8, 4 8s are 32, 2 1s are 2, 2 4s are. So ultimately what we can write down? We write down 4 upon 1 or 4. Clear? Hope this one is clear. Move to the next part. I am moving this side. Hope you are able to understand this one. See this side. Let me switch on the light first. Okay. As the technical error, I am unable to solve this one. See this one. This one. It's a minus 195 divided by 515. Here you can easily understand that here up first part is negative, second part is, means dividend is negative, divisor is positive. So ultimately what we have? We have result as a negative one. So we write the sign negative and then we divide 15 1 ja, 15 13 ja. So ultimately what we have? We have minus 13 as a result. Now move to the next question, one complex type question. Now see this one, this is a little bit complex, you have many division signs is there, near about 3. How we solve it? Let's start. First, for starting of new line, give equal to sign first. Then within brackets, see here, 90 divided by minus 15. So we can write down 90 divided by minus 15. Division sign is there. Now here, what we have? Minus 84 divided by minus 8, sorry, minus 24 divided by minus 8. Clear? Then we have a negative result. Ultimately what we have? 90 upon 15 divided by, here we have positive result, 24 by 8. So see, 15 1 ja, 15 6 ja, here 8 1 ja, 8 3 ja. So what we can write down? It's within bracket minus 6 divided by 3. We can write minus 6 divided by 3. Or ultimately what we can write down? We can write down minus 6 of 3 equals to minus 2. Use these two parts just below the paper, below the this one. Here there is no space, so I use this to write down likewise. Okay, hope this one is clear to you. Now move to the next question. This is the question for finding the value of some unknown variable. Here we can write down 90 upon minus a equals to 5. Question says that find out the value of a, not minus a. Question says that find out the value of a. How we find out? We use the cross multiply sign. Now we remember in this case equality already, equal to sign already given in the question, in the equation. So we use implies that sign for beginning of new line. Hope this one is clear to you. Now we do the cross multiplication. Here minus a is in divide form. Shift that one to this side. 90, 5, minus 1, shift it to this side. Take the sign of multiply, minus in divide operation, here it becomes a multiply operation. Now we can write down 90 divided by 5 equals to minus a. So it's 18 equals to minus a. Now shift this minus sign to this side so that we have a equals to minus 18. This is your solution. One more question is I'm going to discuss with you so that you can easily understand. This one is find out the value of a so that this becomes true. It's a minus 9. Remember, use bracket so that you can easily understand which one is negative, which one is equal to. Now, first simplify. Shift this one to this side, this complete delimiter to that side. Always remember, in this case, first we remove the complete delimiter a minus 2 to this side. So what happened? Minus 81. This minus 9, if it's shift to equal to sign, becomes a operate in division sign. Use the division one, sorry. It's a minus 9. Clear? Equals to a minus 2. Negative, negative, positive. It's a 81 upon 9 equals to a minus 2. It's a 9 equals to a minus 2. Shift only to this side, means minus 2 this side. So if minus 2 shifted to this side, it becomes a plus 2. 9 plus 2 equals to a. Now see here, what we can write down? It's 11 equals to a. This is your solution. This is the value of a. Now move to the next question. Next is you simplify the given expression. I am choosing this one from this book, minus 5. Hope you are able to see this. Yes, it's a good one. Minus 5 within bracket. It's a 6 divided by 3 into minus 2. Close the bracket. Minus 9 minus of minus 5 into 2. Hope you are able to memorize, recall the Bodmas operation, Bodmas process. Now first we try to remove the bracket, then of, then division, multiplication, addition, after that at last subtraction. So let's start. First, I'm going to remove this bracket. Sorry, not equal to anymore here. Equal to. Now keep minus 5 as it is. Within bracket C, this is division sign, this is multiply sign. This bracket is only for the negative sign, to separate these two signs. So first we do this, follow this one. So 6 divided by 3, 6 upon 3 into minus 2 as it is. Clear? Now minus 9 minus minus 5 into 2. So first we multiply these two. So what we have? We have minus 5 into 2. See here, minus 5, 3 1s are 3 2s are 2 into minus 2 minus 9 minus minus 10. 5 2s are 10, minus 9 is as it is. Now, minus 5, 2 into 2, it's a minus 4, minus 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 plus 9 plus 10. So here we can write down minus 5 into minus 4, it's a plus 20, minus 19, answer is your 1. Hope this one is clear to you. Move to the next question. So here we are going to discuss some word problem. First, this question says that the temperature in an evening on a day decreased from 17 degrees centigrade at 4 p.m. to minus 7 degrees centigrade at 10 p.m. Means it is given temperature at 4 p.m. is equals to 17 degrees centigrade. Clear? And same at 10 p.m. equals to minus 7 degrees C. Question says that find the number of degrees the temperature decreased each hour if the same amount decreased each hour. Means what? So see how many hours we have in between 4 to 10. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. They are near about 6 hours. And what is the change in temperature? So change in temperature equals to 17 minus 7. See this one. See here what I solved. What I solved to you that as you are observing, let me use my pen. As you are observing, this temperature at 4 p.m. is 70 degrees centigrade. Temperature at 10 p.m. is minus 7 degrees centigrade. So what is the change in temperature? Change in temperature is 24 degrees centigrade. Total time between 10 p.m. and 4 p.m. is 6 hours. This one is clear. Now come to this part. Change temperature in each hour, 24 degrees centigrade divided by 6, it's a 4 degrees centigrade per hour decrease. It's a decreased one because we already know that temperature is decreasing one. Now move to the next question. Now in today's last question, it is about game. Apurva score in a video game is minus 105 point. Actually, the statement is given, Apurva's score in a video game was changed by minus 105 points because she missed some targets. If she got minus 15 points for each missed target, how many targets did she miss? It's simply division 1. Minus 15 for one missed target. We use the word missed, one missed target. Clear? So total missed target equals to, we divide now, minus 105 divided by minus 15. It's a positive 105 divided by 15. I think I'm question is clear to us. 15 1 ja 15 7 ja, it's a 7 targets. Hope this one is clear to you. Now this is all for division. All of you complete your exercise 1C in your fair copy. Remaining question not discussed in video, they are of same type what I discussed in the with this video. All of you see the examples, see the solutions of those, and then try to solve the remaining one. That's all for today. Thank you.